Hi there, everybody. Welcome to You Buy and I Play It. This is the semi-regular thing where you buy games for me and I install them on Steam and then I play them and talk about them a little bit. Today we're going to be talking about Marlow Briggs. Today, of course, is different for me than it is for you, but lo and behold, like every time I've done this, I have had to play this twice. And so I'm going to be playing through the opening couple missions right for you. Opening mission, really. And just giving you some freewheeling thoughts about what I think about the thing. It's kind of what you're into it for. Hopefully that's at least what you're aware of is going to happen. And so let's dive right into the story of Marlow Briggs. We could be casuals. We could be hardcores. But you can't be a hardcore without beating the game first. We're going to look at normal. You can double press A to double jump. Buckle in and get ready.
Damn, it's hot down here.
You fight fires for a living and you're complaining about...
So we're already establishing some things. A, this is Marlow Briggs. He's the protagonist of this game. B, he's a firefighter. C, he has some sort of romantic partner. Who works in the most heavily militarized archaeological organization in the world.
We're out of here soon.
Yeah.
Ah, Miss Torres. Lovely to see you again.
So immediately everyone that we are introduced to is some sort of racial stereotype.
Yes, but...
Excellent. And you are?
Marlow Briggs.
Marlow's my boyfriend. He's visiting for a few days.
Well, we can always use more workers. Now, Miss Torres, I believe you had an update for me?
Yes. We've recovered the last major codex, and it appears to be in remarkable...
There's codices. It's kind of Tomb Raider light. I really like the framing of the shot. There's the woman in the back left. You know she's very important, but you don't know why. But lo and behold... We're going to find out soon. So this is more of an exploitation media kind of plot. I thought it might be just kind of a straight up, just kind of like a straight up game, you know, in the realm of Tomb Raider or something like that, where it kind of leans into action adventure and does other stuff as well. But no, we're very quickly going to see that it leans very hard into the patently ridiculous, starting right now.
Marlow! Get your hands off me!
Back up! Let her go!
Mr. Briggs, I'm afraid I'm going to have to let you go. Distraction in the workplace will not be tolerated. Kill the boyfriend.
So we're going right to murder. We're going right to hostages, to murder. But he's not going to be shot. Instead, look at this business. This prop is so weird and big and giant, and not even, like, part of this universe, that it doesn't fit correctly in anyone's hands. It doesn't really look to scale. And he's murdered in a way that seems like it is physically impossible. I can't imagine how that big pointy thing actually gets through his body to kind of lodge there. There's no god here. He's a comical executive evil man. And then... Cut to some other stuff. I thought I was going to cut a little bit quicker, more quickly than that. I'm sorry. I thought it was going to be a little bit more exciting when it happened. These people, of course, are so evil as to be faceless. But they also wear, like, Midwestern United States survivalist clothing. So, things can happen. A little bit of humor there about a workplace accident. It's been 0 days. Hoo-hoo. So check this out. He's dead. He's lying on the ground. And we cut to this. Which I'm not sure if it implies that that the whole thing burned down. And now he's here on the ground. Maybe we're in a, like a dream world. But this is happening right now. So now this guy is full of, like, mystical Central American Maybe Aztec? Not quite sure, honestly. I think that might actually be in the title of the thing. What kind of culture this might be in the title of the game. But, so now he's just going to go on a literal revenge fairy tale God of War style. And I mean God of War very, very explicitly, as you'll see in just a minute. But he's going hard for it. I love this. Look at this little guy. Look, whoa. So we're directing him, I guess. I don't know what that's actually meant to imply. So I'm over here on the left. I'm kind of running around, and we're just going to have some snark. These are called Kukulkan's Fangs. That's our swingy thing we got. And I love the weirdness of this game aside, and it's kind of like Unreal Engine look to it. I mean, this could be a Unity-style game, but it really has that Unreal like lighting and texture style to it, the kind of bulkiness of the character, so who really knows? But, or, I mean, we could find out, I guess. But what I really like is like all this playing with perspective. So check this out. So every time things happen, there's lots of zooming in and out. I have to get these mind masks to gain health back, but there's all this play with perspective. And I really like this kind of industrial, like, organization trying to... Or this industrial organization setting up inside these ruins and all this stuff. So my overall impression, and it still has this kind of like Tomb Raider style feel. This feels a lot like the most recent Tomb Raider reboot stuff in visual feel and what we're supposed to be seeing. These are experience points over here. I think you can gather them with the B button. Uh-oh. Perspective gets weird. Or you can just smash into them. I prefer the smash method, of course. Oh, no, I have to hold B for this one. There's no way. So we're going to do this little beautiful thing right here. I actually got really confused on this earlier, especially because you can pull it toward you. What I'm doing right now, that's not what you're supposed to be doing. You have to push it forward and watch this. Look at this. Look at this beautiful vista. Look at that over there. That's great. But our kind of mystical demon mask guy, I'm not really sure what he is. Feels like there's something wrong, and I love this comedy beat. Which is the most wrong possible that could be there. It's smashing the ruins with these big like comical pipes that literally make no sense. But sadly, I think after this, it's a lot less interesting. A lot of killing these dudes who are like coming at me with, I think that's a kukri. I think that's what those are called. So they're going to start coming at me, and I have to do just the most boring, hacking and slashing to kill them. I got to chase this guy down. Didn't even do a good job of it. Come back, bud. He's going to, like, signal a helicopter, because in just a second, we're going to see a helicopter come by. I don't need that health. And I'm just having to do this a lot, which is a real shame, right? Because whoever did, the art direction and the art asset creation on this game, doing a great job. You deserve accolades and awards, but just the kind of gameplay that this is a part of is... not really the most interesting for me, I'll have to say. Dude swinging big bladed thing over and over again, doing some dodges. It's not what I enjoyed about the PS2 era, and it's not what I enjoy about games right now. But then we have this really great thing, so I'm gonna push this right off a cliff. That glitched out for some reason. I hit the A button in the middle. Didn't really work out. So now I have to, I'm going to kill these couple guys. Three guys. My mistake. So I'm going to do some slicing and dicing. You see some nice weird shadow stuff happening in the background. Once again, just beautiful, beautiful place. And I think that's maybe the most disappointing thing about this opening level, and I would venture to guess about the entire rest of the game, that so beautiful, so interesting, or at least theoretically interesting. Only to do this kind of thing. So now I have to, like, deflect bullets back at this guy. And it's really hard. I mean, you might be laughing at me. You might be thinking it's a comical moment and I'm not good at it. But that rocket goes real fast. And you have to do it at the right moment, and it's a kind of a really, there we go. Kind of a, it's kind of got like a little of a pull timer, maybe. It also, like, I don't understand how that physically, what's actually happening there, but it's fine. It doesn't really matter, so check this out. Hooah! So Marlow Briggs is the coolest zombie in human history, as far as zombies are concerned. So there's a guy over here, and I can kind of slice him up a little bit. You can see that helicopter back there. Gotta avoid the helicopter. Lots of helicopters are going to be throwing themselves. Just pause to look at this nonsense that's occurring. But lots of helicopters are going to be throwing themselves at me. My cat's making a huge amount of noise. Going to be throwing themselves at me over the next little bit of this. And it's a very weak vehicle. I think if you were a mining company, a resource extraction company, and you were investing in a lot of helicopters as your primary means of assaulting the undead, newly risen boyfriends of kidnapped victims, you might want to rethink that strategy. And as you can tell, you know, I'm playing on normal, as you saw before. And normal is pretty easy, I'll be honest. I'm going to say that and then I'll die to something goofy. So now I can grab this guy and execute him. Or it could be a woman. This person. It just means throwing them into the top of this weird, fake, semi-Golden Gate Bridge. Primonero or purification plant, and I just love this environment design. Whoa, gotta get out of the way of those guys, and we're gonna scoot on over here. I like the AI there a little bit, that they're gonna get out of each other's way and they're gonna try to shoot me, but gotta kill them first. Gotta get rid of these baddies, because they're a lot more difficult to deal with than these guys who are coming at me with kukris. You would think that with such an expenditure like this, and I believe we saw guys during the opening intro with guns. Of course, he was threatened with a gun at the beginning. You'd think they'd go with that. You think you wouldn't come at a guy with a giant, double-bladed, scythe, I guess? Double-bladed scythe? A God of War weapon. You think you wouldn't come at him this way. I'm stun-locked somehow right now. There we go. Okay, so now I'm going to shoot down these shoppers, and I really like this little section. It goes on a little bit too long, but they just start throwing these helicopters at me, and we're doing some real, like, Call of Duty or Medal of Honor, like classic Medal of Honor, shooting down the helicopters using these big shooty things here. Really like it. Really like this kind of, like, old, like, PS2 era, turret shooting, I guess. Now, I was just complaining about the PS2 era before, but maybe it's just that, you know, cutting dudes up and running around and doing that kind of thing. I've done that for probably thousands of hours of my life, and as far as turret shooting is concerned, I don't know how many games have devoted long segments to that. So, maybe it just feels fresh. Marlow Briggs, bring in the fresh content. I think I can't do anything about that one. Yep, challenge completed. Go me. So I'm going to upgrade the only thing I can. Very unclear about what that even means. And we're going to jump up here. Whoop, grab this ledge. And scoot on inside this ore purification plant. If you've ever been around industrial machinery and industrial factories, you know there are no signs like that anywhere around these places. I really like the idea of the design of this room, and I want to talk about why in just a second, but notice that little train track over there, that little cart track, I guess, over on the left side of the screen, and right under me right now is a broken track. So this game does a weird little thing right after this little sequence. So, of course, because it's a brawling game, I've got to carve my way through these fellas. And then something interesting can happen. These pistons over here to the right are really gonna mess up my day in a second. So when I played this before, so what's happened here is I've beaten these dudes up. And Marlow Briggs there, you can say, how am I supposed to get through that? It's all these pistons. It's very confusing. So when I played it before, the screen actually didn't zoom out. So I was just up there in the same little fight position up here in the front, like I've always been. But if you come over here, lo and behold, there's a cart here with explosives. And it took me a minute. I was kind of wandering around figuring out what I was supposed to do. Yeah, look at this. And this is what happens. So this dude, this like, you know, I don't, demon mask thing, it's just kind of a jerk to you and says, oh, go do it, and tells you explicitly. So I wonder how many people in testing didn't know what to do. So they had to kind of implement that fix. Or maybe none. Maybe it's just in the original script. I don't like jumping puzzles. Not my thing. But I think I've gotten this one figured out pretty well. It took me a lot longer than I would like to admit in my initial attempt here. And so now they're mixing it up. All the enemy types I've seen before. Oop, gotta get out of there. Ooh, let me go over here and get some health. Woo! But yeah, so, you know, I've seen the rocket guy. I've seen these melee fellas and this... Whoa! This flamethrower person. And now they're all getting thrown into the mix together. Very Jedi power battles. Big fan of Jedi power battles. Like, comment, and subscribe if you love... Oh, come on, throw him. Jedi power battles. Alright. And gotta do a little bit of... tapping. Gotta tap. Listen to mine. Tapping the button. So, up there... Lots of experience over here. They're really making sure you understand where the experience come from. Love this view. I mean, come on. You can see exactly where we need to go down there. You can see that kind of line that connects it with the little lights that go down it. So you know what you're supposed to be doing, but just a beautiful vista to look at of horrifying, industrial destruction in Central America. Presumably Central America. So we're doing some double jumping here and all the way up to this ledge where we have to painfully crawl over to the right. There's a great sludge river down there. Big fan of sludge rivers. And then we're going to hop up onto this thing and ride it all the way down. And now we're going to get an audio log, which is seems like a strange implementation. But, also what she says is really weird, so let's listen to that.
Marlow, I heard from the guards that you survived. How is that possible? The legends of the ancient artifacts imbued with the power of resurrection, all the sacred warrior stuff, can't be true, can they? I guess I'm hopeful enough to leave you these messages. Don't worry about me. I'll do whatever Long wants, and I'll be back as soon as I can. He promised not to hurt me or my family. I'll hide these notes for you whenever I can. I love you.
So presumably this is a hidden note, which doesn't make a lot of sense, being that it was on the ground somewhere where she probably wouldn't be. I can imagine. Gotta get my little EXP over here. And it's really interesting that when I'm doing that experience, it kind of pulled that camera angle up. You can see these trucks in the... Oh, come on. Those trucks back there. Look at them go. Heavy business. Love the simulation of business here. So gonna do some more door opening. Listen to that strong work. Arr, the molten ore facility. Gotta do the molten ore raid, and this is kind of the big boss fight at the end of the level. And it's a little clunkily designed, I'll be honest, but I think it's actually pretty cool. Get a weird zoom in here. I love the way the camera works. Just very unlike most video games. Which is great. So yeah, so this is a first-person fight, boss fight, where you just shoot these... you just shoot these hydraulics. Like, that's it. That's all you're doing. So, they're exposed, and you shoot them. And you shoot them a little bit. And they go up. And the problem is you have to do this, like, forever. This goes for so long. I guess I can't shoot it from behind either, which is a real, real bummer. But, yeah, nothing really happens as far as I'm aware, at least in my first playthrough. This helicopter shows up. You can just kind of lay into it a little bit. It doesn't really matter, I have so much health, it's comical. Yeah, you shoot the helicopter enough, it flies off, but I love this idea that you're just kind of tracking around. I wish there were like four or five different things I could do. I think that would be really, really brilliant. It'd be really, really great. So I'm going to actually speed this up, get it to the end. Okay, so I've done both of them right now, and you kind of like teleport and clip. That was not an edit. And you're being captured by this big thing. And presumably if you let this go on too long, you get squished or something. Yeah, you can see the camera is getting all weird here. But you shoot that thing right there in the middle of your screen. You know, it's a big red. Falls into the Terminator 2 lava pit. And Marlow Briggs starts cutting dudes up again. We're getting very close to the end of this level. And I think that the plotting and the patterning, the kind of pacing... and other P words that are alliterative with one another, I think they're all really, really fun and excellent. I can't say I would be interested in playing through the entirety of this game, but as far as something for You Buy It, I Play It, and something for just having some critical thoughts about the design of maybe contemporary God of War clones, you know, I think it's a useful little endeavor. I might check out a little bit more. A little quick time event, classic quick time event, QTE. And I missed that last one. Sounded like my, it sounded like my door was being opened by someone. It was super scary. I'll be honest with you. Wasn't paying attention. Let's cut back to me doing it right. And now we're punching this guy. And, this just goes really slowly. I mean, this is the end of the level. It's this weird kind of single, quote-unquote, in-the-camera edit. Which is kind of unique to video games. I can't really imagine, or I take that back, I can 100% imagine how you would do it with a film camera or in a film, but I think this is a cool and little unique little thing. I can't say that I think the slow motion murder is particularly interesting, but I do like the, you know, it's almost 300-esque, almost Tarsem Singh's Immortals-esque, a much better version of the same kind of concept, by the way. And there's just a lot of kicking, a lot of hitting going on. You know how much I like kicking and hitting in a video game. Very curious about where he got his God of War style mystical tattoo. And I wonder if he had it before he died. Hard to know. So this is going on forever. And I don't even know what he's doing right here. I think he's like maybe powering up to fly away. He's shooting flames out of his body, I believe. Something like that. But anyway, if you like this video, check out the other things I've made. Look in the description for this piece if you want to see other You Buy It, I Play It videos. This will be part of the playlist for that if you're interested. But this was Marlow Briggs. Look at that little mask. It's flying around after it. What an interesting game. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you're not possessed by a demon. At least not right now.